Hi, I'm Megan Maczko. I play Xena in The Ninth Cloud. It's just wonderful to be able to share this film with a lively audience here in London. You know, we made it a short time ago, and then to be celebrating the film in the place where we shot it is really special and cool. Well, the film is, in short, about a woman's flawed quest to find the meaning of life. And before the film starts, she's lost her parents in kind of a mysterious plane crash, and she's ostensibly an orphan, and just trying to find her way in the world, and not knowing exactly what the best way to do that, and so falling in with some very strange and quirky characters, and for me, it was really an interesting challenge to play this very idiosyncratic character. In a kind of heightened format, and yet, like, you know, find her freedom and wildness and all of that. So it was great. I think that we had a very open and fluid conversation before we started filming about the backstory for Xena, and you know, it isn't completely modeled off of Jane's experiences, but in a way, there are characteristics that Xena shares with Jane, and so we kind of talked about that kind of stuff, and there was nothing ever prescriptive with her, and I think that, you know, women tend to kind of like mull things over, and you get to a finished product by kind of... the word that's coming to mind is meandering, and that sort of seems like ineffectual, but it was really satisfying in the end to kind of have those conversations and then get to something that was very direct and concrete by the end. Xena falls in love with Bob, Michael's character, and, you know, he doesn't, the feelings aren't reciprocated by him. And so to placate her at first, he tells her that he's gay in order to avoid hurting her feelings. And then certain things are revealed later so that she understands that maybe that wasn't the case in particular. But he's this... theater artist, starving poet, trying to make you know, immersive art in East London, and you know, it's a far cry from a lot of the characters that he's played in Quentin Tarantino's films and all of that stuff. There's no chopping off of the ears and all of that, but he's an artist himself, and a poet, and he's published some poetry also, Michael has, and so maybe this is a part of him, a side of him that people haven't seen before that's great to be revealed in this film. That next film is called The Velvet Gentleman, and it's about the French film composer Erik Satie, and I play this German Dadaist character who's really sort of eccentric, and there seems to be a theme running here with the characters that I play in James' films, but... yes, why I'm so fascinated to play this character in particular is because she's sort of been written out of history. She really existed as part of the Dadaist movement at the beginning of the 20th century. And, you know, as things went on and history started to document that period, she was all but omitted from it until just before her death, and so it's a great opportunity to rewrite something that should have been written to begin with in playing this character. I think that independent cinema has the freedom to maybe be more realistic or nuanced, dynamic, and tender about how we tell human stories and allow characters to contradict themselves or not satisfy an audience's expectation, which ironically, I don't think audiences want us to. I think we want to see our lives reflected back at us through the art forms that we enjoy or expose ourselves to, whether that be painting or cinema or theater, and our lives are complex and nuanced, and so we want the stories that are told about our lives to reflect that.